Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. We are in Daggerfall, and I actually did a few things in between the last video and this one. I sold all the stuff that I got from the previous dungeon. I think it was the ruins of something. It doesn't really matter at this point, does it? And I essentially have this mod that enables me to order stuff. So I ordered an ebony star for my character because of roleplay reasons, essentially. And this does nothing actually, it's pretty cheap as well, 2500 gold or something, and it only does like 5 to 12 points of damage, which is horrible stats for an ebony weapon. It just trumps the ebony dagger by a little, and it's a two-handed weapon at that. It sucks, but I wanted my character to have a staff, and that's the entire reason that I got this. The second thing I did was I went ahead and deleted all my spells and used some of the remaining money, as well as added some money through cheats, so that I could just go ahead and modify the spells that I'd made. For example, I had made spells that would give me benefits after I'd reached cross level 20. I changed that to make it like per 3 levels. Now, this might be underpowered, I don't really know, but it is quite nice. I mean, the earlier shock spell I think cost me around 70 or 80 spell points to cast. This one cost me fairly less than that, significantly less than that actually, and does much more damage per level, per 3 levels at least. Yeah, even per level it does do much damage. So things like that essentially, like revamping the entire spell list. Lumos, like these spells, I noticed that the duration doesn't really depend on you get the duration bonus as soon as, well, from level 1 itself. So I just went ahead and made sure that the duration bonuses were per 20 levels, but I also made sure that, there's a Joe Mama, yeah, right here. So again, for this I did keep the duration rather conservative. But yeah, for the other spells which did not have any damage effects or did not damage the enemy per se, I just went ahead and kept the duration levels at 20. For example, Lumos and then Aqueous Form. No, actually, that is still per 3 level. I also added like a Clairvoyant spell to help me detect the quest item, and Nullify Mana. This is like Wizard Rend, Nullify, Turn Undead, Leech Vitals. I also decided against getting like a few spells. Now these spells, I actually got these from leftover money, and so I essentially just made all these spells out of 5,000 gold, just like the previous time around. Anyhow, so for today's, I don't know why I still have this Lumos spell effect activated right now, to be honest, because it should have been long gone. I don't have any mana to cast it anymore. I suppose it's because I don't require mana to cast it at this point. But one of the things that I want to do in today's video is essentially go over to the Temple of Kyne. So that, let's get onto a card first. Yeah. So that I can essentially get a quest from them, which I can then avoid doing, so that they kick me out of the guild. My reputation, I think, is already at 4. Let me just go ahead and confirm something once. Yep. Nah. It wasn't too, but I wonder why I'm getting such low frame rates. Who knows? At any rate, so this is the way, yeah, this is the way that is supposed to be headed. I like the fact that it actually shows you an arrow on the map to help you understand which way you need to go. There it is, the Temple of Kyne. Let us just accept a quest and never do it. And after about a month at most, we should be kicked out of the temple, that is. So what I want to do instead is go ahead and join up with some other temple. Yes. Oh, sorry. Yes, are you the quester then? Yeah, I can buy spells from you, but no offense, but I can only assist certain members, certain high-ranking members. Are you the quester? No. No, you give me training. Are you the quester then? Not you either. I can't even make a donation there. At least the donation system in this game isn't like bugged out. Daedra summoning. Hello, naked ladies. kindly excuse the dogs shouting outside. Is their favorite pastime? I think you're the question. Oh, you helping make spells. You must be the question. Yep. A house over in Benpath Dairy is being haunted by some sort of undead. We need someone to exercise the spirit. Are you up to it? It pays 225 gold pieces. Remember, if the haunt is too tough for you to handle yourself, just get out of there. No one will blame you for saving your skin. The place is called the Wickfield Residence and it's in Benpath Dairy. You have 16 days or we send someone else out to do the job. Now, typically, this is like one of those zombie slaying quests. I would have been able to do this, but we are trying to essentially get to a point where, you know. Ooh, this looks nice. Yeah, sorry for being sidetracked there. We are essentially trying to get to a point where we get kicked out of the guild of this temple so that we can go and join the temple which gives us potions. So that's what I'm going to attempt this. So instead, what I'm going to do this in this level is I'm going to hit up the local bar and I'm going to ask around for some quests from there. As soon as we can spot a tavern, I feel like that's the important bit that we're missing out right now. Oh, is that a tavern? Yes, that is. Right there in the distance. Hi, horsey. Can't I grab you? Can't I, like, pet you? I thought Daggerfall had, like, this, kept count of, how many animals you pet. The flying dragon. Barkeep. Okay, you do not have anything for me. Typical people inside bars have some of the other kind of work. Not always, but sometimes. You've got nothing either. Alright, let's just look for some work. Greetings to you. I need to know about employment. Goody Woodfield asked me to look for people like you. Go find him at the Emperor's Hawk Shop. The Emperor's Hawk Shop, huh? Well, the Lumos spell is finally faded away. So that's something, I suppose. The Emperor's Hawk Shop. You the human. Where is... What the fuck is the Emperor's Hawk Shop? Is it an alchemist? Nope. Listen, I don't give directions to people who talk to me like that. Okay, I'll be blunt with you then. Previous list. Armors? I don't think so. I'm definitely not the Bank of Daggerfall. Nope. It's strange that Daggerfall only has like one tailor. Gem stores? No, that's. We already checked those. Jewelers. What's this again? Oh, yeah. Emperor's Hawk Shop. Nope, nothing here. I think that was. General stores, yes, libraries. Daggerfall Lyceum, only one library. At least it does have libraries, so that's, I suppose, good. The Knights of the Dragon. Pawn shop, perhaps? Yeah, the King's Hawk Shop. Emperor's Hawk Shop, yeah, that's the one we. Why on Tamriel would I want you to know, strange bird? Okay, one more attempt. I reckon a little more wandering around will make a right good improvement in your manners. Let's try asking him. Freaking Breton, always begging his common folk for help. What have you done for me lately? Begging your pardon, but that's such a stupid question. I don't think I should have to answer. Of course I know where the Emperor's Hawk Shop is, but I don't want to tell the likes of you. Alright, where the hell is the Emperor's Hawk Shop? You're strange, but I don't think I'm going to tell you where to find the Emperor's Hawk Shop. You then. What was it again? Was it a pawn shop? Yes. I guess I can tell you, it's a way northeast of here. Thank you, kind stranger. So that's what happens when the charisma is low. OG Daggerfall never really implemented this. This game does, like DFU has, and keeping like a low charisma is bad for your character. So So that's Castle Daggerfall, right? Wait a minute. There's a way to get up there? Like, getting through up there? Holy shit. That's interesting. That might just be the Emperor's Hawk Shop. Probably because it's right next to Castle Daggerfall. But then again, it might just be the Pink's Hawk Shop. You never know. Yeah, there are like doors all over the place there. I actually want to go and check them out. See whatever's there, you know? I mean, it would be amazing if it just... Emperor's Hawk Shop right here. If it just leads you into like a... The shop is laid on a practical and safe manner. All the items seem to be of adequate construction. Probably just entrance to... alternate entrances to the castle itself. Oh yeah, correct. Talk. I've heard of you. Nothing good, of course. Get lost. Oh wait, right. I think the person who needs a quest done is upstairs. Excuse me. Strange bird, I have found you. I've been looking for you for many days. I have an important job for you, but may not tell you more unless you promise you will promise to do it. Alright, good. Now what I'm about to tell you, you must promise not to speak of to anyone else. I am a vampire. I was infected many years before you were born, and have since become one of the worst, most powerful clan leaders. However, another is rising. A pitiful excuse for a vampire, but others listen to him. He speaks out against me, trying to destroy everything I spent hundreds of years building up. I need him dead. Go to the Loten Nest where his filth resides. Kill him within 24 days. I will be waiting here. The Loten Nest. Now, my strategy for tackling these quests is pretty simple. I take what I can get and I leave the rest. Essentially meaning that... Well, essentially meaning that Can I cast teleport right here? Yeah, I don't have the spell points for that. Let me just go and just stick around here to regen some of my spell points. I've heard that teleporting inside buildings is never a good idea, but who knows. Anywho, I'll just stick around here. Now, what I'm gonna do is... I'm just gonna... What was that? Seemed like those, yeah, this. Oh, the tree outside the place is phasing in. I see, like morphing in. Yeah, so basically, what I want to do is delve into as much of the dungeon as possible. And if at any one point I find the dungeon to be too difficult, I'm just going to get out of there. Bestiary. I thought I already had a bestiary, didn't I? Yes, I do. Wait. Yeah. How much is this again? 600 gold? Yeah, I don't think I want it. That's all it says. Okay, fine, I'll buy it. Who knows, it could be useful. You never know. So this is the result of another mod. Hook and Rope. It allows you to climb onto places that don't really have a wall for you to climb onto. Makes life convenient. If the first call of Bandar, yeah, Broken Diamonds, Special Thor of Tamriel, King Edward, maybe, I have the gold for it. Alright, let us go and read a little. So what I was seeing is, why does this need to be a book? It just opens up the best year for us, but it's fine. Yeah, all top and front of the water. Perfect to contract a disease from a zombie. Imp. Are these... I think I've... defeated more enemies, to be honest. Oh yeah, the skeleton monsters didn't count. Did they? Okay, monsters. Two imps. Okay, that's literally the extent of all the enemies that I've defeated thus far. I think they should give me like a boost. Nope. It does not. That was a waste of money. A waste of perfectly good money there. But that's alright. That is alright. No issues whatsoever. 2 kgs. Might as well keep that in the wagon. Right, so as I was saying, what I intend to do is essentially, here, let's just cast like a recall anchor right here. Teleport. Cast. Anchor. Yeah, cool. So what I want to do is, if the dungeon gets too difficult, I just want to like exit and nothing else. That's literally what I want to do. So where did I have to go again? Haunted House. Yeah, I'm not doing that at all. Rivalry among vampires. Diluted Nest. Alright, let's go to Diluted Nest. Yeah, right here. I'm gonna kill as many things as possible. And I'm gonna get out. So that way I'll be able to grind up and level up organically. Without, you know, hacking the game, so to speak. Alright, let us go then. Maybe I should... Yeah, fine. Because I need to repair this as well, it's like thoroughly used. Once it's broken, it'll just disappear from my inventory. That is a no-no. That seems to be the way in. Typically in these cases, the tree is where you want to be headed. Look at the geometry. Oh man. Okay, the Loten Nest. I just hope I don't contract vampirism or something because of this. Fine, let's try it with this. I think vampires can see through invisibility as well, but who knows. I honestly feel like this quest might be too difficult for me as a beginner. Wait, really? That was simple. So I see that the path behind me is also locked off, so that should probably make my choice simpler for me. There are enemies nearby, of course I cannot rest. Because there are enemies nearby. Alright, so I guess we know where we have to go then. Good thing I saved. Good thing I saved. Alright, I'm invisible. Don't know what good that'll do me, but yes, I am invisible. Probably should have cast Lumos when I had the chance. Long skirt, fancy armbands. Right. Ooh, look at this Iron Maiden. Wait, I can interact with this? What? No way. Really? How though? Wait, I got hurt because I was touching that, was it? That's interesting. That's really interesting. Alright, maybe I can cast Lumos now. I can see some human enemies there. They're fighting each other. I say let them fight. I'll just recast invisibility when I can. I tried creating like a sustainable leech vitality spell, but like any transfer spell is also pretty... What do you call it? You guys are taking too long. Actually, let me hit the human. Help out this brigand for a bit. Hi. Okay. That guy was a ranger. Hi. So, shock spells actually work now. Yeah, I'll see the rest of my... spell points. Alright. Root tendrils, northern root tendrils. 45 gold pieces, yellow rose, black rose, that's fancy. chain curse and leather boots. Alright. So, should I? I can't climb up there, that's for certain, but yeah, I could probably head downstairs. Or I could go in there. This is like the... Yeah, I can hear skeletal warriors, which is never a good sign. Okay, save too. I'm gonna frequently keep saving, because, well, I don't want to, you know, end up as a meal for a skeletal warrior, essentially. We are seemingly exploring this side first. So I sometimes wonder if Lumos even does anything. It does actually do stuff, but it's like, interesting. That's probably because I'm probably advancing in stealth because I'm invisible and enemies cannot detect me. My spell points are back up, so which is, I suppose, a good thing. Let us try shocking this bitch again. See, they actually work now. Time to cast invisibility again and let it regenerate up. Excuse me. Alright, we're moving on. That's another Spriggan there. Not really what we're looking for. Some venom has scarred the wall. Interesting. I heard some objectionable thing there. Look at this, it works now. That's like the most amazing thing ever, isn't it? Just that fireballs do cost like a lot of spell points. I wish I could rest, but I can't. Alright, I'm gonna save it with this save slot. What's here? Another Spriggan. Let's try shocking it. That did not work. I can hear something like just moving about. I don't know what it is though. It has nothing. Let me try resting here. Yeah, that's good, that's good, that's good. Cool. And Lumos. It does actually make a slight difference. Just a slight one. Which should I save? This one? Might as well, right? So thus far, this adventure has been going swimmingly. And the moment it stops going that way, I'll just get out of this dungeon. And we'll call it a day. Lock is not interfering from me, huh? Let us try using password. Face password, sorry. Aloha Mora. Look at that! But this place is nothing? Okay, why did I come here? So I'm using as many spells as possible to essentially level up all my spells, so... Like, look at this here. Blunt Weapon and Destruction are already ready to upgrade to the next level. Illusion and Thaumat Alteration are also increasing slowly, probably because I'm using... What do you call it? Invisibility as much. Took me a while to find that word, didn't it? So this is all like this is ready to level up as well, I think. Illusion, I mean. And as for minor, look at this. Mysticism is also slowly improving. So is medical. Not as quickly, but so is medical. It's already like 25 my shot rate, my god. Stealth, critical strike, backstabbing. Interesting, interesting to see how all of this works. Restoration, I've not been casting heal spells as much. I need to start doing that. Let me go ahead and update a save. This one. Okay, we came from there, so I suppose we need to head here. This way. Actually, I think I can, like, take on one skeleton. And martial combat? Yeah, I can do that. Holy shit. I did not expect to see you there, son. You of all people. Well, that's a point for restoration. And it actually heals me a lot. What's going on? How did my restoration spell become that powerful? I should probably like keep spamming this. This is a long enduring battle. Good thing I've got like heal. Holy shit, I actually killed the skeleton. Well, talk about blind luck. Alright, time to update the savior. My blunt weapon, a critical strike, and a lot of... Wait, the skeleton came from somewhere here, didn't it? I'm quite certain that it did, it just appeared out of thin air from here. Am I going insane? This is where the skeleton came from. There's like a... supposed to be like a hidden door here. What's going on? Or did it just... climb up the side or something? Ooh. Yeah. Good thing with the Daggerfall tooltips thing is that it will actually tell you something like it's like a puzzle piece. Which honestly eliminates a lot of dead spriggan. How's their alter? Oh, maybe the skeleton killed it on the way here. How did they detect you from so far off, I wonder? Shall we take a left here? Let's go. Corners are clear. Now, I'd actually never imagined myself to be clearing corners like this. Like it was an FPS, like a tactical shooter. A Daggerfall of all places. But here we are. Anybody here? Yoo-hoo! Excuse me. Alright. So, I wonder... what do we need to do to improve our thaumaturgy then? There have to be some spells that target thaumaturgy, right? I'm just curious to know which spells those would be. Okay, there's like that section over there as well. Okay, we're going upstairs. It looks... there's a sprig in here. It was shocking, wasn't it? What's... holy shit, how the fuck did you hit me so hard? Out of nowhere at that. You gave me a fig. I'm healthy. For now, from the looks of it. No hidden doors here. Let us go ahead and update the save, perhaps. Actually, let us rest here, yes. Yeah, right here. And now update the save again. Anything in here? Nothing. Cool. It's a rat. A hat. I don't know why I like saying that, I just do. Actually, let us search through Mama. Yeah, I don't know what happened there. Okay, we're seemingly going back down again. Have you been here before? Yes, we have. Yes, we have. It's the same intersection that we choose to not get into. So I guess... oh wait, there's a couple of hidden doors here. Seems sort of... standard, to be honest. And there's also this little section right here that I do wish to scribble upon, though. That's not what I wanted to do, but I just wanted to, like, write upon that area. But apparently that's, like, too... oh yeah, right here. Ascend. So this is, like, something that Daggerfall Unity has. you can like ascend, like you can write down notes on places. So yeah, and it can like help you figure out the path better. So yeah, right here. Okay, I see a human. Time to hello. Burn him. And freeze him at the same time. I don't even know whether I did any damage or not. Save was a spell mead. He died to my spells, that is an achievement for me. Pick white robes, round shield, chain quirs, leather greaves. Okay, I've definitely become stronger. Especially with my spells. I mean, I didn't think I could do this before. Are we safe? Okay. Excuse me again. So when the game isn't spamming enemies at you, it's really quite a pleasure to play. Daggerfall. Old Daggerfall. Not dealing with the vampire though is going to be... I think I hear... I mean, I definitely hear a skeleton as well, but I think I also hear the vampire. That room didn't have any like hidden doors or anything, did it? I don't think so. Does not seem to be the case. See, one of the I was like having a discussion with a person over on Reddit who's like an old veteran of DFU, and we both collectively agreed about how Dark Shield or Buckler. Dark Shields are nice. I don't think I really want to mess with this thing, but oh well. Let us shock it instead. That thing is like, what the hell just happened? Okay, let's rest here. Okay, there are enemies nearby, we cannot rest here. Look, where are the enemies, I wonder? I can hardly hear them. Because this room does not have any hidden doors. I guess they're at the very base of the tower over there. So this area seems to have almost been completed except for this, yeah, little ascendant portion right here. So let us go back and cover that side. The enemies sound right next door, to be honest, and it's making me a little teensy-weensy bit uncomfortable, but I suppose... How the fuck did you see me, bitch? That's what's most entertaining about Daggerfall. Let's try this spell. Save versus spell made. For now. I'm practically playing like a rogue right now. Okay, dragon scales, those are interesting. Let's just rest out in the open once more. Alright, we're cool. Excuse me there. So unlike the older games, Daggerfall has like a system where it you actually do how to, yeah, so my strength is pretty low. My strength is literally 55, so I constantly keep failing climbing checks. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna go ahead and use float to get up there. Steel short sword, priest ropes, let's go. I love priest ropes. I've got no idea why, but I do love priest ropes. Hey, I don't even need to like press the space button or anything to maneuver here. I feel like I've already been here though. Oh, is that the vampire? Holy shit, how are you so quick? Good thing I made that save there, because holy shit, I would not have been able to fight this one if this were like a fair contest. But I now know where to go to try and kill her. Alright, so let us load the save up again. Alright, since we now know where the vampire is, let us go and attempt to kill her. Now, Float, I will be utilizing this, but we'll go right up. I don't know why I use that. Oh yeah, the priest ropes. So Daggerfall, I do believe I've told you guys this already, but Daggerfall has persistent loot, meaning that... let me go and just fireball her ass. Where is she? She's supposed to be right there. Yo. Got a leg. You can't catch me, you can't catch me. Come here, bitch. Come here. I'm gonna hit you so hard your whole world would spin. I mean, it's fine to use hacks like this. Holy shit. Okay, let's head back down for a moment there. And, let's, try healing, perhaps? Okay, can we, like, stop at one point? Can we, like, stop moving, please? I'm trying to get you here. I got in a hit. That's all I could really ask for. Okay, time to head back down. I don't know how long this float spell is gonna cast. Gonna last, rather. Vampire is dead. The vampire clans will be pleased with you. Holy shit, I didn't think I could actually defeat a vampire in this game. But this is thrilling. This is actually thrilling. I guess skeletons are also sort of broken in this game. alright, save number 2. Let us override the save. Hello, I would like my frames back, thank you. Okay, I am healthy. So what we can do at this point is, instead of heading all the way over to the exit, we can just go ahead and... How do I... Yeah, the C button. I prefer binding it to the control key, so maybe I'll go ahead and do that. Anyhow, so what I can do right now is I can just teleport back to the anchor that I'd set. Alright, there's nobody here probably because it's like, what's the time right now? 8:07? Yeah, the store's probably closed. So, when the store is closed, I've heard that you can actually steal things, so let me go and try that. Yeah, that was a quick save that I just made. And, let's see here. I've got some oil that I can, like... Yeah, you don't even get, like, an option to buy things anymore. Let's, like, steal, like, a lantern and an oil. And bracelet, yeah, we could probably... get it, who knows. Small statue, common symbol, steel saber, helm, buckler, can get with part 7, dubious tale of the crystal tower, rude song, etiquette with rulers. Maybe, let's see. Let us grab as much as we can. Ooh, that's an enchanted talk. I can probably try my identify spell with that as well. Real Perenzia. Now this is like a really nice volume, or rather, a series of books here. King Edward Part 3, Brief History of the Empire, the Wild Elves, Parchment, probably with nothing on it. Landmark Journal, now this is a holy tome, let's go ahead and take that as well. let's get everything that we can, we're gonna steal the shit out of the store right now. Even though it probably should not be because, well, I wanna save all that for my playthrough, but yeah, I can't help it right now, I'm just having too much fun. Let's put this away. Notes for Redguard History, on Oblivion. So yeah, the Queen Perenzia novels are really good, so if you get a chance to read them, you should read them. I mean, apart from the other sex stuff, it's like really well written. King Edward, I actually have not read King Edward yet, so I don't know how good it is or it isn't. Here's hoping that it is really good though. Now of course I don't want to go through somebody's personal belongings, I just want to rob there's two for what it is worth. What the fuck is going on right now? Shop shelf. Holidays, Real Berencia, Fool's Ebony, The Fall of the Usurper, Poor Scroll of Antar. Okay, let's keep it, who knows what it is. I don't know if this fucks the game up or anything, but yeah. I'm also invisible, so which is probably helping me, like, Origin of the Mage Guild. Yeah, let's go with Legend of the Lover's Lament. I've heard of stuff stacks in this version, and I can see that it is true. The Tale of Kaden. Yeah, it's like I'm inside the shop, but I'm also not inside the shop. The War of Bethany, Red Guards. Let's grab some more oil. Landmark Journal, we already took that. So yeah, like I was saying, Landmark Journal, it helps you. It's basically Mark and Recall, but for cities and towns in the exteriors, essentially. That's what it is. That's what the Landmark Journal is useful for. Alright, let us... what's the time again? 8:21, so I guess we shall have to wait, like, for an hour. Yeah, there you are. Hey bro, I killed the vampire for you. You have done well. The vampires will not bother you for a long time because of this. We will meet again, Strange Blood. I know it. Now, it sort of excites me to know the possibility that I am going to get, like, that I can finally meet vampires now. Look at that! That's a really efficient heal spell. My god, how did I make that? What's the formula? I surprised my own self. This, it's not heal. This is like the normal heal spell. Yeah, magnitude 1 to 10 plus 5 to 10 plus 1 per level. And what did I heal wounds right here? It costs the same as heal, but it's... Yeah, 1 plus 1... 1 to 1 plus 27 to 38 plus 3, per 3 levels. Okay, now this is a really powerful heal spell, but it sort of makes me wonder, just how many hit points do I have? Do I have like 40 hit points or something? No, I've got 75 health. How does it manage to heal me up so much? Huh. Interesting. I guess that how it works is that for things that are your own, you don't really... Like, for things that affect you, you don't really need to wait until you cross your level bar to use those things. Let us... Oh, right, it makes me nude. I forgot about these. Maybe we'll sell them. Etiquette with rulers, the holy tome. We'll read them at our spare time. 24 oil, all stacked up like that. Look at that. Alright. Yeah. Okay, I'm glad I actually took on a vampire and defeated that bitch. Like, I have no animosity against them, but I'm just saying, you know? I'm just saying. I sort of do want to cast Identify as well. Identify... Where is it? Oh wait. Divine Knowledge, I believe is what I called it. Where is it? Divine Insight... Oh, right. Wait, I don't have the spell... Oh, right. Right. I haven't had the spell points for it yet. What's going on here? So I guess that's one of the spells that I did, like, screw up a little. Huh. Alright, I guess we're headed to the Mage's Guild then. That was like a full successful quest, and I'm really happy that we could actually manage to successfully complete that quest. I did not think that I would be able to do that. I mean, when the game isn't spamming enemies at you in bunches... I mean, skeletons were a tough fight, and so was the vampire. I literally had to use exploits to fight her. But I would definitely not have been able to face her in like a fair one-on-one fight. But, I mean, apart from that, it was nice. It was nice. And, I mean, magic really is overpowered in the Elder Scrolls. It's really something else. Especially if you craft it well enough. And surprised at how easy it is to like how less custom made spells cost you, not monetarily. I mean, perhaps even monetarily, but as far as the casting cost is concerned, I just want to quickly check something here. Yep, restoration has increased by a huge margin because of that. Thaumaturgy is 1, so I guess teleport is thaumaturgy. That's fine, I mean, illusion is invisibility, isn't it? So what do I need to level up alteration then? I guess I need to be using kind shield for that. Yeah, I should probably start using kind shield more often to level up my alteration. Oh yeah, and also I was thinking about messing with the supernatural in this game, and when I say that I mean trying to go ahead with the vampire questlines and you know, the werewolf or werebear or werebeing questlines if possible. And yeah, I'm quite pleasantly surprised that I managed to find a vampire so easily. And with the way he says that we'll meet again, strange bird, I know it. It sort of feels like I would be meeting that, as in I might just get invited to like a vampire questline because of that guy. Alright, we're back. Let's go ahead and raid this place then. The last time I went to some place that was called The Web, it was actually a place full of Daedrots and other kinds of Daedra. So I hope that's not the case here, but if it is, well, we'll do what we can. Well, at least I don't see any enemies right off the bat, so that's a good sign. Of course there are enemies. Oh no. It just had to be a skeleton, didn't it? I can even hear it moving about. Why do these things scream so loud? Alright, let us try breathing this then. Oh boy, I think I made a mistake coming here. Yep, I did. But the hit rate of this weapon is like far higher than my previous weapons, to be honest. I'm saving mana so that to go ahead and essentially heal. The skeletons are still like a tough fight, but at the same time, okay, I need to heal. One of them is dead. I'll go back. Come on, die please, will you? At least, I mean, two skeletons, I feel like I can handle them. And I could. That was an intense fight. Very intense fight nonetheless. Let me go and rest here. Alright, dodging and blunt weapon have improved. Let us go ahead and update our full seat then. Right here. We have already looted you Dwarven Warhammer. This could sell for like quite a bit of money, to be honest. Priest robes, and I don't really want skirts. Too bad these things inside the dungeons aren't lootable. Short skirt and long skirt. 24 gold pieces, an elven longbow. That could also sell for money. Long shield and a giant scorpion stinger. Let's see how long this dungeon takes to, you know, completely explore. It's strange, the top layer of this box doesn't always render properly. I can hear things like, you know, rats here, but apparently there aren't any hidden tools right here, so I feel like we should be fine moving ahead. Let's put some stuff in the wagon, such as this, the Dwarven Warhammer. Even though it definitely does like far more damage than whatever I have equipped right here. 5 to 20 points, look at that. I mean, it will level up my hand-to-hand skills as well, sorry, my blood weapon skills as well, but that is not the character that I want to play. Let's go ahead and update the savior. And are there any hidden tools right near the entrance? I don't think I saw any, to be honest. I don't think there are. Alright, heading down. I hope this place does not have like a whole bunch of other skeletons. Just checking for hidden doors along the way. I don't think there are any. Okay, time to turn this corner. And let's see. If we see an enemy, we'll promptly just hide away. I hear something there. Sounds like a spider. But I suppose that is to be expected of a place called Web. Look at that. That was a miss, I think. I mean, we can rest here, so that's at least a good thing. Can I not? Thank you. Took a while there. I'm mostly just resting to, you know, regen mana instead of waiting about. Let us go ahead and cast invisibility nonetheless. I was saving it in case. Yeah, let's go here. This area is full of skeletons because invisibility will not help against them. Alohomora, right here. It's a slightly expensive spell, but. Well, it's just a bat, to be honest. Daggerfall sometimes has this issue with the steel flail, fancy armbands. That is essentially just a mute mod. It makes your character mute, is all it does. I feel my character getting stronger, so that is something that's good. I see another locked tool here. Any other hidden tools, perchance? I do not suppose so. Interesting. Actually, let us go ahead and use. Where is it again? Alohomora. Let's try that once again. Excuse me. It's like the unlock spell doesn't really wait for me to, you know? Oh, yeah. Sorry about that. It's like the unlock spell doesn't really wait for me to actually hit the prompt. It just more or less does it on its own. Okay, so we came down there, went in through there. That part should lead to... Yeah, it does join up here. So at least we've completed the circuit now. Okay, let's choose an area to explore later. Let's place a marker down here. And yeah. Let's head back this way. I don't see any hidden doors. Two parts here. Let me drop another marker right here with the word explore on it. And mayhaps another here with the same word. Oh, okay. It might be one of those places, you know? The ones where you have to, like... Yeah, there's like a mechanism outside that you can use to essentially just disengage this gate. And I remember when I first started playing Daggerfall, I had to do something that was pretty much essentially the same thing. I can't even hit anybody here. Except for this one guy here. Whom I'm almost missing every single time. Yeah, you just let them stack onto each other like that. And just hoot them that way. Some venomous card of all. You should meditate about what you've learned about stuff. I feel like I might be hitting the wall there. Looks like this skeleton is able to hit me. Spell was absorbed. Oh yeah, I can do that, I forgot. Six gold pieces. Well, I'm glad to see that my spells are actually working. After much practice, you feel ready to advance in deception, which is exactly what I wanted. So where is this thing that I needed to manipulate to move the time crate? It's supposed to be somewhere around here. I just need to figure out where though. Let's go with Mega Savior, because that could not have gone better. This can't be it. It is. Why did it not tell me? Why did it not tell me? Okay. 27 gold pieces, 5 arrows, 21 gold pieces. A silver mace, that's gonna sell. Alright. Right then. More loot. But typically this Edric. That's another piece of clothing. Fancy gear that we can wear. Now typically this place also has, yeah, exactly, like a door right here. Actually, let me just go ahead and update this area. The falling encounter is like pretty difficult but in a fun way. Yeah, so the vampire is down there. That much we know. Right around this corner actually. Vampire is dead. The vampire clans will be pleased with you. Holy shit, that was so difficult. That was one difficult ass fight. Took a few tries, but man, is magic overpowered or what? I'm sorry, the spell points for that. Alright. I should not have healed there, but oh well. Spider said. I'm just grabbing all the loot that I can here. Steel longbow, chain boots, leather greaves, sandals, potion of resist poison. Amazing. There's like another entire section there, but let me, before I go in there, let me just go and save you. I can't believe I literally defeated two vampires in a row. That's like a lot to ask for from a level 3 character. I mean, I know I totally got my ass handed to me for the most part. But at the same time, I'm paralyzed, am I? Free action then. So free action is a low-cost spell, and I only like to use it when I get paralyzed. So when am I headed, and why am I headed here? Just for the fun of it, I suppose. One more spider, just to find what other loot there could be, I suppose. Spider's also dead. Yep. Here we come. Dragon scales, Babo's Dusk. Had a short shot. Yeah, sure. Why not? Gold piece 35. Leather right pauldron and a kimono. Okay, I didn't know this game had kimonos in it. Straps are literally just another stripper mod. It makes you wear. Well, stripper straps. I see a bat there, and this place is actually expansive. I was not expecting this place to be so expensive. Yeah, this place seems to go on forever. It's like, this place has got like entire areas. Like, there's like an entire underground module to this place. I guess that's how they decided to continue the entirety of the dungeon. Let's just go ahead and... Actually... Can I not, like, delete this note somehow? Yes. Double right click. Alright, so with that being done, let us go ahead and teleport. Yeah, I want to teleport, not set an anchor here. That would suck. There you are! Victona Greencroft. I'm surprised that teleportation is working, like, reasonably well. And our game is lagged a little. Probably because all the assets are slowly loading in. Look at that. It looks so lovely outside because it's probably in the middle of the night. Yep. Better spend it in the company of this pleasurable vampire then. And since I'm invisible, she should probably be able to see me just fine. Because she's a vampire and all, you know. Okay, let's not grab her. Let's talk to her instead. You have done well. The vampires will not bother you for a long time because of this. We meet again, strange bird. I know it. Thank you for all your money. I love taking your money. Edric. Sandals. Resist poison. Resist frost. Kimono. That does not look like kimono at all. Okay, we have both tusk and dragon scales. Hi. You're now, you're a vampire, aren't you? Aggressive greensmith. You serve the clans well. What do you need? Tell me about the Thieves Guild, the vampires. Maybe tell me about the vampires, why not? Being a vampire seems like an interesting proposition. Just that I will not be able to do any quests for temples. Or maybe I can just grit my teeth through the damage that I get from there, from being there. The Order of the Lily, the Crusaders, the Underking, the Necromancers. Yeah, there's nothing about the vampires here. You should know about the vampires, shouldn't you? You yellow-eyed freak. Question still remains, which... Haunted House. 4 days left. So what should we do now? I mean, it is sort of dangerous to venture out into Daggerfall in the night. So we should probably not go there. Although we do have like a spell of how about this, a resist poison, but at the same time, probably not a good idea. I'll give you some privacy. You also look like quite a charming person to have for company. I haven't seen you here before. My child, my poor Godlister coppersmith is gone, stolen away by the Dark Brother of Kynareath knows what hideous purpose. You must help me, strange bird. I will give you all I have, 314 gold, if you will bring my child back to me. Sure, you're my savior. I was wondering why she's there because I didn't see her there in the dungeon the last time, in this place the last time, and I figured, you know what? She probably has a quest for us. My name is Evelipith Vicroft. Quickly now, for you only have 24 days before they kill Gondistir Coppersmith. He's being held in the Kingston residence in Hurston Manor. Is that so? This seems like one of those more interesting quest lines. Theodian Coppersmith, now give me some. I'll have some meat. Yeah, meat sounds good. Actually, give me some beer. Right. And let's just chill around here for like... Let's just rest for like 12 hours. So that it's morning. It's raining outside, that's interesting. That is really interesting. I finished loitering around here. Excuse me. Sorry about that, I had to cough a bit. Oh, you're the person who's playing the flutes, is it? Interesting. Okay, alright, it should be morning by now. And it does rain, but the skies aren't that bad, to be honest. I do like the particle effects in this game, especially during rain. Okay, so typically this might just be one of those quests where we might get a letter from somebody, but I'll not spoil the quest for any of you guys. It was one of the earlier quests that I'd done as well in a warrior playthrough of mine, but this seems like one of those interesting quests. So let us go to this place that she talked about. Abducted child, Hoodstone Manor. You can cancel travel from the world now. I can do that? What? Excuse me? Man, the queue of changes. And it even loaded up so quick. The quality of life changes in this game. My god. Okay, I want to know more about this. Agreed to rescue him from the Kingston residence and okay, Kingston residence. Pretty sure that I'll have to defeat some human who will have more information about wherever this child is being held, and I'll have to go into that dungeon and free him myself. The thing about this quest is sometimes, actually that was like sort of a different quest which is similar to this. Yeah, that's the Kingston residence. This is where we need to go. Alright, let us make a save here. Treat it as a dungeon. You hear, welcome! Kingston residence is dark and ominous. It is certain that enemies lurk everywhere. Yeah, I don't think I can like rest here for a long time, can I? Of course, there are enemies nearby. And I don't even have my invisibility spell to depend on. What should I do? Let's just stand right here in the corner for a bit. I really do want to cast invisibility. How much will it take me? Did I call it invisibility this time as well? I'm not certain actually. Aloha Mora. And the spectral change, yeah, that's what I called it. Hopefully I have enough points to turn invisible soon. I'm invisible now. Amazing. There are no enemies here. None that I can see there. No one messes with the Dark Brotherhood and lives. Hi. You're gonna die soon. Steel Dai Katana. Helm. Iron Greaves. Chain Boots. Why not? Let's take that help. Nonetheless, who cares? And because officially... Ooh, that makes a huge difference. Alright. Yeah, let's make a save. Who knows whether we'll be... whether we'll be successful the next time around or not. Oh, you seem to be the mistress of this house and a pretty stunning one at that. I think, like, I installed a mod. Which... whoops, not that. Good to know that I have the spell points to cast. Another one. It's just like one of those cases where the game will just spawn enemies every now and then. A helm. Alright. Let's go and check out our helms first. Plus three. Yeah, let's just remove these. We can actually access a wagon from here, so why don't we keep this with us and put these in the wagon? Because yeah, somebody's gonna want them. Oh, I was looking for you. Are you here to rescue me? My name is Contessier Coppersmith. I don't like these people. Please take me back to my family. Why not? Let us kill you as well. For the pleasure. Ooh, that was powerful. Oh, another one. Another prey for me. Two hits and you're dead. So if I'm ever low on mana, I can just spam fireball and get all that mana back, essentially. Interesting. That'll teach you to mess with innocents. 2 minutes in mana. Now the problem now is that I cannot remain invisible anymore, and I hope that I don't get any more, you know, folks that assault me on the streets. I'll try to protect this child to the best of my ability, but who knows what's gonna happen. Anyhow. Should have cast Mark and Recall there, actually. Is that an enemy? No, that's not an enemy. Just Daggerfall. Alright, let's time to get on the cart. And we have our little wand equipped. I think I was supposed to head to right here, the King's Fairy. I think that's where I got the quest from. Yeah, the King's Fairy. So we head all the way northwest. There's a considerable amount of distance between me and them. The question is, when I attack any random person on the streets, the guards are immediately sent after me. But if somebody attacks me on the streets, nobody comes to save me. Why is that? That does not seem fair. We are headed northwesterly with a child on our back. This quest actually went by sooner than I expected. I did not expect this quest to go by so soon. Let's just go ahead and identify this building for a minute. Vintage Smith. Gotcha. If I recall correctly, the inns were somewhere in this direction. Forgot to use slip boot. That's honestly. Actually, you know what? It's literally in the same place. I can just... Yeah, I can't cast it anymore. Shit. Oh well. I mean, the anchor is already set. We could have just teleported to it instead of taking the long way around. Yeah, we are in the correct direction. I don't know what that is though. Oh, just a blob of the Black Wolf. That is the King's Fairy, I do believe. Yes. Look at the chest. Perplexed Elizabeth Evelabeth Vicroft. Yeah, you should be perplexed. Gondister Coppersmith, you're alive and well. Strange, but I owe you a debt that can never be fully repaid. This modest reward is the least I can give you. Alright, if you insist. Plus 6, that is interesting. It's the same as this one, right here. And I think maybe I should get my Holy Dagger repaired. Holy Dagger. More like Ebony Dagger. The savior of my child, I thank you, and Gondistray Coppersmith thanks you for saving his life. Bless you, Strange Blood. Glad to help you. Glad to help you as much as possible. Now, will you speak to me? Yes, you will. Interesting. So, I guess my reputation among the people has been constantly on the rise. So, that seems good. Now, we still have like 2 days left for this quest. So, the question is, what do we do next? Go to Inglefield. I feel like I've met you before. I'm looking for someone that won't faint at the sight of blood. Human blood. For 353 gold, would you kill a man? I should have saved before I interacted with this guy. I'm interested to see what he has to offer. But at the same time, I don't exactly want to be an assassin. You never saw me. Gotcha. Good day to you, Strange Bird. I never saw you. I should start doing that more often. Yeah. Forgot what I was about to do there. I'm looking for a very special book, one that is not available in any store, at least not for any price less than astronomical. Recently, I've heard that a copy of it has surfaced not too far from here in the dungeon. If you will accept this quest to find this tome, I will give you 38 gold pieces now, and another 318 gold pieces when you return. Do we have a deal, little strange old? Sure. Good. I'll give you 14 days to get the book out of at Vorin Laboratory and return. After that time, the 318 gold pieces will be forfeit. The name of the book is King Edward, Part 8. I saw that book in the store. I literally saw that book in the store that I was in earlier, that I was stealing stuff from. And you want to send me to a dungeon to find that book, when you can literally buy that book for that price. You are irresponsible with your money and others' lives, sir. Good luck to you too. But at least it'll boost my reputation with the merchants. So that's good, I suppose. Alright, let us wait around here for a bit so that we can cast a teleportation anchor. In case things was out there. Or, you know, in case we manage to find the book. Alternatively, yeah, I can't really do that. I was thinking maybe I could like cast a teleportation anchor near the entrance of the dungeon. I could probably do it from the inside though. But it's alright. I mean, we only have like 2 days to waste here, so might as well be instead doing this. I'll set the anchor right here. And let us go! Daggerfall. So where are we headed again? At Vorian Laboratory. I love this feature. You notice an acrid odor, you notice a strong acrid odor. I don't know if you guys caught that, but I was reading up the text that was appearing atop the screen there. But better be somewhere here. As it is supposed to be. Is that it? Yeah, that is it. Why are all these things inside like holes in the ground? So the benefit of doing all this is that we're getting lots of combat experience. And that's all that really matters in this game. Like literally everything hinges around combat. There are enemies nearby, oh shit. Alright, let's just That sounded a little strange. I don't know what that is. I've heard that sound before, but I can't place it right now. Is that a lich? Maybe, maybe not. Okay, let us put a bead down here and just leave it as is. Excuse me there. That's a zombie. But I don't really want to fight it. Actually, yeah, I do. Let's fight. So good thing about swinging towards enemies is you don't really score unless you hit them. Like, they don't get loot unless you actually manage to land a successful hit or it's a parry. After much practice, you feel ready to advance in blunt weapon. This guy's dead. Invisibility is overpowered in this game. But with that having been done, let us go and save you. Alright. Moving on. Let us practice our Aloha Mora spell. That was simple. It's like the open swirl actually makes the door loose, even if it does not completely loosen it up to opening. Aloha Mora, can I cast it? Or maybe that's just the power of our ebony staff. It must be the staff of unlocking then. What is this thing? A healthy battle mage, hostile. Battle mage aside, that was easy. Can 2 points really make that much of a difference, or am I just getting better with my weapon here? What's going on? At any rate, this dungeon is invisibility friendly. So yeah. I probably heal like a saber-toothed tiger or a bear or something. Another zombie! Hi! Hi! Okay, you put leather pauldrons on you, which is sort of interesting. I'd not expect you to be the type to have leather pauldrons on you. But my magicka is actually passively regenerating. Do I want to cast a little more right here? Of course, it's a benefit field. Can we like... Yeah, sure. Why not? But yeah, we should rest often in this game because that more or less just... Maybe one more, a little more. Let's try. What do you mean, locked too powerful? I thought you said this thing was ready to open. I hope this is not a magically held lock. That does not lock. Hello, Mora once again. Oh, okay. Oh, alright, I see. Sometimes you just can't fail to cast the spell itself. And that's what happens. Should I really be breaking down the durability of this thing here? By doing this? Finally it opens, and there's only the full 70 part, the 5th, and rainwater, apparently. That's a alchemical ingredient from the looks of it. Let's just rest here. And overwrite the save, because why not? Actually, yeah, I was about to save after doing that. Excuse me. I was originally intending to save after doing all that. And yeah, King Edward part 8 essentially. And what book did I just get? I don't think that is the book because yeah, Fools of Me part 5. I think it's that story with the Argonian that I've narrated before in my warrior playthrough, where that Argonian, you know, metalsmith competes against that imperial metalsmith. It's a very nice story about knowing the context and the battlefields. I think it featured Queen Berencia and her husband essentially. And they essentially had this little, not her husband, but I think one of the ministers in that place. They had this little bet where they wanted to see, they wanted to launch an invasion into, what's that place called with all the Argonians? Black Marsh? Yeah, Black Marsh. They wanted to launch an invasion into Black Marsh and, oops. I just confirming that I have actually explored all of this. I have, so let's go ahead and remove that. So where are we headed now? Let us go ahead and place, oops, dots there, and because we are headed left first. Hi there, lots of you guys here, aren't you? Oh, more loot. And a holy dagger. Holy dagger! You can come too long in the midnight sea. What is becoming of me? And what is this to again? If only I knew. Oh, wait. Are those like... Wait, I think that actually brought this... all over. Right. Why didn't I think of that before? We'll get there later. It's that module. Alright, I got you. This thing is not a teleporter, touching it will do nothing. This is the switch for the same wall over there. Actually, I believe it is for a different wall. Yeah, I think this unlocks the gate downstairs. That's a strange lever. But at any rate, I'll just go ahead and override the save here. Yeah, I decided to go ahead and override that save. Hi. Yes, you see, that was a parry. So he could immediately detect me. The Quiris, yeah, nothing too special here. This door in what's that level called again? Isle of Belfair, Metora's hideout? I don't remember exactly. Yeah, so that is another huge way forward, so we'll just go ahead and explore this place first. Hit this side first. So let's just go ahead and keep marking these places so that we don't forget about them. Actually, that place, let's just go ahead and remove that and place this here. Typically, this section opens up in a huge pyramid of sorts with various... Oh, that's the book, King Edward, Part 8. Should we? Yeah, might as well. I hate using the... Oh my god, that was powerful. I guess she is just as weak as I am. Tablet of Arcane Knowledge, let's go. Oops. Alright, save the game. Right here. Good thing I decided to check this place out. This is exactly what I needed. Alright. Now. Whoops. Yeah, we have failed that quest, so let us just return current location. What? Oh yeah, right. How do we... Yeah, teleport. And let's teleport back. Oh, marvelous. Here's the 318 gold pieces I promised. Thank you very much, strange bud. I'll happily take your gold for all the effort that you made me go through. Fool 70 part 5, but I might as well have read that book, you know? Sure, this book is too advanced for me, fine, I'll keep it for use later. I wonder what I need to improve to actually go and read that. How did you see me? I'm invisible right now. Are you a vampire? Huh? Are you a vampire? What the fuck are you trying to whisper in my ear, son? Huh? What are you whispering in my ear? Are you a goddamn vampire? Answer me when I talk to you, son. Answer me when I talk to you, damn it. Fuck you. Who looks just like the Fire Skull Quester? The Vicfield residence is still haunted and I should speak with thee? Yeah, I guess we aren't getting kicked out that easily. Or maybe we need to get a quest first. A house over in the Screaming Hedgehog is being haunted by some sort of undead. You need somebody to exercise the spirit. Are you up for it? At least 147 gold pieces, sure. Remember, if the haunt is too tough for you to handle yourself, just get out of there. Who will blame you for saving your skin? The place is called the Buckingham Residence and it's in the Screaming Hedgehog Inn. You have 14 days away, sending someone else out to do the job. Right. Our order demands retribution from a former member who was turned traitor. Will he be the strong arm of our fury, strange bird? Sure. Very good. The traitor is a killer who has taken refuge in the ruins of Moorfield Manor to the northwest. If you have not returned in 9 days, your honor will be forfeit and another will take your place. Do not fail us in this, strange bird. Sounds like a nice quest to get kicked out of the guild with. So let us go ahead and do it. So how long do we have to waste traveling? 8 days. Cool. Okay, so since we have 8 days to waste, we might as well just follow our previous route. Crosscode Field and this Cath Tower Hill. Pretty bleak place this one as well. Alright. Now back to Daggerfall. We should definitely have failed this. I don't know how many of you caught that, or whether you even did, but I said we should definitely have failed this quest now. Okay, Temple of Kyne. I mean, that is like the faster way to waste time. Yes, I don't exactly mean to end the video in such an uneventful note, but at the same time, I felt like I've had enough adventuring for now, and my butt hurts from all the sitting that I've been doing. So yeah, excuse me, I'm just gonna end it like this. But to make it up for you, up to you guys, and to my own character, for the benefit of my own character, I mean, I'm gonna be doing temple quests for whatever next temple it is that I join. So if this does not kick us out, we'll just let a month pass by and reevaluate then. Strange, but you have been a disappointment to us lately. You are hereby ineligible to receive any benefits available as a member. Perhaps you will come within the fold again, but for now, you are anathema. I'm quite sorry to disappoint you, sir. Okay, bye! Yay! Freedom! Alright, so that's what we set out to do this in this video, and I just tried making it a little interesting by completing side quests in between. But I decided, sort of forgot the in-between part and just kept accepting the side quests as I got them. And as a result, we completed like 4 side quests for the Commodores. So, yeah, that's that. So, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. The next time we come back, we will be joining another temple. Now, the last time as a warrior, I joined the Temple of Dibella. I do not want to join the same temple again. I will join one of the other temples that does not give us any spells. There are only 2 temples. One is Kyne, and I think the other one is Julianus. So, I think what I'm going to do is join the Order of Arkay, which worships the Dragon God of Time, Akathosh himself, and we can pretty much just grind up there until, you know, I mean, this playthrough is one where I do want to focus on the temple, so we'll be grinding up all the way up to the highest rank possible there. Hi there, what's your name? I'm not even going to try and pronounce that too long. Alright, so I'll see you guys then. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow. Thanks.